हेलो हेलो
हेलो मैडम मैडम
हेलो
कैन यू हियर
यस
मी?
सर हेलो
ओके
यस
ओके सो
आई कैन हियर यू।
आई विल ओपन द स्लाइड
ओके
नाउ.
सर ओके सर
ओके मैम गो अहेड मैम.
It has not, it's not showing the display, sir. Is it started?
हाँ आई ओपन. कैन यू
It's
सी द स्लाइड्स?
showing
आई
that it's
ओपन.
waiting for. No, I cannot see the slides.
आई ओपन इट. नो मैम.
Now I can see that.
ओके
I can see the slide.
गुड.
Okay. Good evening, everyone. I am Azim Unisam, Assistant Professor from Department of ECE, Hyderabad Institute of Technology and Management. And the co-author for this paper was Dr. Pratibha Nagbhushan, Professor from Psychology Department, St. Mary MacKillop College, Canberra, Australia. Today, I'm going to give a webinar on my work, that is attendance in class and motivation to study in an engineering course, exploring their association and gender differences. So as you see from the title itself, the very first word is very catchy, the attendance, because in most of the situation, not only in the cities, inside in cities, in states, around country, attendance is one of the biggest challenge, and mostly in our engineering education, it's very difficult to control the attendance. So this is one of the study which I and in collaboration with Pratibha Nagabhushan, I have done this. So we'll be going across the presentation and the study which we have done, which is trying to relate the attendance with the motivation to study in an engineering course. So next slide, please. Hello.
Yeah,
Next
ma'am, I've
slide.
changed it. I've changed it. Highlight
Okay.
this one.
So the highlights of the presentation, you can skip, sir. The next one is introduction. So in the introduction, you can see that there are a lot of research has been done by the researchers related to attendance, as because it is one of the biggest challenge. In introduction part, you can see carefully that the researchers have tried to focus on attendance and its comparison with the results. They have found that if there is good result, that means that the attendance of the student is also good. The poorer result shows that his poor attendance in the classroom. And they try to find out the correlation. There is a negative correlation they have found between absenteeism and the poor results. So most of the researchers has focused on attendance compared with the results. So if the results are poor, that means that the classroom attendance was less, he attended less classes, and if it results was good, then he attended more classes. So this what the researchers, all previous researchers has done the work. Now the study which we have focused is relating the attendance with the motivation behavior of the students. So the next slide, my research questions for this is nothing but how did the attendance is related with the motivational behavior of the students. And for that, the hypothesis is it is expected that there could be a positive relationship between significant relationship between the attendance and motivation behavior. And the second research question which we are trying to address is that is there any gender difference between students for the attendance and motivational behavior? And we have stated the hypothesis for this is there could be gender differences between student attendance, students motivate, and the students' motivation behavior, that is at the study management and study planning. So coming to the methodology, next. In methodology, we have four things, that is participants, instrumentation, procedure, and statistical analysis. These are the four parts for the methodology. So coming to the next one, that is participants. Next slide. In the participants, we can see that this study was conducted for the students of a course called probability theory and stochastic process, and the course was taught by me. And the students, number of students who have undergone the study were 98 students. Out of them, there were males and females. And also, this study was conducted for electronics and communication students from Hyderabad Institute of Technology and Management. Now, coming to instrumentation, next slide. The instrument designed for doing this survey is nothing, for doing this study is a survey, which was designed with a questionnaire based on the student attendance and their interest to study and their motivational behaviors for 20 questions from a Likert scale from 1 to 7, strongly disagree to strongly agree. And this instrument contains the questions related to attendance, study management, and study planning as a part of motivational behaviors, where they say that I'm interested in the class. After attending your class, I have become more and more interested to attend the class to study. And they said that I am interested to attend more lectures. They said that I plan my classes or my plan my study before doing this, doing the work. So this kind of questions were designed as a part of instrumentation. Next procedure. Next slide procedure. On the procedures, if you can see that the survey of 20 questions was administered to the students and they completed the survey. And this survey, after the completion, it was make sure to the student that this data will be kept confidential and they have to just answer this in order to, we want to find the rate of like attendance relation with the motivational behavior so that the students can give a proper data to us and then giving just a 1, 2, 3 or ABC like kind. So we got a data from 98 students, and after collecting the data, then comes the fourth part, that is statistical analysis. The next thing, so next slide. So as a part of statistical analysis, we have conducted the statistical analysis for the data set using SPSS version 24.0. As a part of statistical analysis, we have done descriptive analysis, statistic analysis, descriptive analysis, and we have also examined the Cronbach alpha for testing the reliability of the scale. And we have done t-test, ANOVA, and also Pearson correlation in order to examine the means of the given variables. And so these are the tests, these are the things which have been conducted as a part of statistical analysis. So after the analysis is being done, then what is being projected from the result? Let us go to the next slide, result. So in the result slide, you can see that the first one is a descriptive statistics. The descriptive statistic help us to get the means of the given scale, that is attendance, study management, and study planning. So if you observe from this, that the students report higher levels in the attendance and in the study management with the mean or 5 point something, I am not able to see that, and 0.88 in both of them. And they have scored a low level value in the study planning, which has a higher level of the standard deviation. And in this, the Cronbach alpha is also calculated to test the reliability of this scale, whether these parameters, the attendance, the study management, and study planning are significant for the further analysis on all. And the study shows that the Cronbach alpha test, which is checking the internal consistency of the scale, got the alpha value from 0.60 to the 0.69 range, which is moderately strong. So these three variables, the scale, attendance, study management, and study planning, can be further considered for the analysis. So coming to this, after checking the reliability of the results or the parameters, the second part, which is nothing but the hypothesis one, relating whether there is a correlation or there is a relation, positive relation between study planning, study management, and attendance, was being considered. So the table two shows the matrix, correlation matrix, with attendance, study planning, study management, and similarly study plan 1, 2, 3 indicates the attendance, study planning, and study management. So in this, we can observe that there is a star mark which shows that there is a significant relationship between the study planning and attendance. And there is also a significant relationship between the study planning and study management, and which is found at a significant level of 0.01 level of significance. And then we can also observe that there is no significant relationship between the study management and attendance. So this is the first part of the question, which where we were trying to find out whether there is a relation between attendance and the motivation behavior, which includes these two parameters, that is study management and study planning. Now coming to the next part of the research question, trying to find out the gender differences. So next part, next slide of the result. So in the gender, in order to find out the gender differences, we have administered a test called ANOVA, analysis, one-way analysis of variance. This is used to find out the significant difference between two groups. So in this result, it shows that the star mark, you can see on the star mark, which indicate there is a significant difference between male and female in attendance and study management, where you can see that the female has higher level, reports the higher level than compared to the males. And that we did not get any significant difference in male and female in the study management at the significant alpha level of 0.05. So this is the gender difference which we have observed from the result which we got. Now coming to the discussion point, second, next slide. So as part of the result which we have seen, we can see that there is a significant relationship between attendance and the study management, and there is a significant relation between study planning and study management. And the next part, coming to the next part, if you see that there is a gender difference exists between the males and females for attendance and study management, and where females report more higher level compared to the male. So considering these, the positive relationship between the attendance and the study planning, we can say that if the students attend the class, then he knows what is being taught in the class. So if any assignment is given or anything, he know what all work to be done, what all things has to be managed. So he can do better work by doing attendance, by attending in the class and planning his work in a better manner and manage his studies. So this is a part of the discussion. And the other thing which I want to do as part of the conclusion is that the gender difference, if you see that the females report higher levels, so that means that male students need more assistance in terms of getting motivated to sustain their interest in the course, and also to attend the classes and to manage their studies or plan and focus on their studies by developing their motivation behavior skills in this and to the focus towards the study. The second thing which I want to say, that since we have seen that there is one of the important role of attendance is to make the students sit in the class, so it's a very challenging task. So the current finding shows that the importance of attendance. So in order to make the student attend the class, the faculty members need to adapt the engaging practices of engineering education so that they can motivate the students to attend the classes and to make them focus on their studies so that they can plan and organize their studies. And other thing is, based on this study, we can tell that the teaching and learning practices which have to be adapted based on the males and females so that the attendance can be improved. So if I say that this all things has to be done, the faculty need to improve, then there is a one important word which it's like a variance, that there is faculty development programs has to be conducted, which should be addressing innovative teaching technique. Without this, a faculty cannot know that what are the things has to be conducted, what kind of pedagogy to be followed in order to engage the students or in order to make their class more practical so that the students can enter the class. So it has to be conducted in a day, in a regular basis, not in an end of the 1 year, or it can be some 2 years once like that. So keeping the student, keeping the faculty abreast of the newly development in the pedagogical era or pedagogical things which are being developed in the engineering courses will help to make the classes more engaging so that the student can get motivated to come and organize their class. So this is what from the discussion. So like every study, there is a limitation. Coming to the limitation of my study, This study was conducted in an urban context where education has more importance. So if the study ended to for a simple college, single college sample. So if the study would have conducted in a rural area context, then the results would have been more promising and as part of the gender differences and all. So that's what I want to conclude for the things which we have presented. So the agenda of the study was to see whether attendance in class and motivation to study are associated with each other and their gender difference exist or not. So the hypothesis which we have tested shows that it has both relation of attendance with the motivation, and also it shows that there is a significant gender difference exists in both attendance and study management. So that's all. Any queries, any question from participant? Hello.
Thank you, madam. We'll just give them 1 or 2 minutes.
Hello.
Hello. Ma'am. There are 2 questions. In case they come by email, I'll forward to you, ma'am.
Yes.
Okay. Thank you, ma'am.
Thank you.